Tonight, we're continuing our special series examining the impact of climate change on states bordering the Mississippi River. Yesterday, we brought you stories from Minnesota and Iowa. Today, we travel from Missouri to Louisiana with reporting on the environmental and economic hazards of rising waters. We begin in Labadie, Missouri, where one of those hazards is coal ash, the residue created when coal is burned. The U.S. produces more than 100 million tons of coal ash every year, and storing it carries the potential for toxic materials leaching into groundwater. NewsHour Weekend's Ivette Feliciano has our story. This special series is part of our initiative Peril and Promise, the Challenge of Climate Change, and is produced in partnership with Nexus Media News, a nonprofit news organization.
Labadie, Missouri, a town of just over 3,000, sits on the southern bank of the Missouri River. A notable site is the Labadie Power Plant, the largest coal-burning plant in the state. It's owned by Ameren, Missouri's biggest energy supplier. In burning coal, the plant produces a byproduct, coal ash. Both the plant and the ash stand in what's called a floodplain, an area next to a river or stream that is prone to flooding during storms. That's a point of concern for some here, because coal ash is known to contain heavy metals like arsenic, chromium, and lead, which can cause cancer, respiratory disease, and cardiovascular disease in humans.
Earlier this year, there was at least 10 to 15 feet of water standing at this location. So imagine that over this entire area.
Patricia Shuba is a resident of Labadie and the founder of the grassroots nonprofit Labadie Environmental Organization.
Does the location of these coal ash sites concern you?
It absolutely does, because floodplains are used for filtering water. And so to have that waste that contains heavy metals and carcinogens sitting in the water table is really not good.
When it opened in 1970, the Labadie power plant stored coal ash in basins called ash ponds, dug next to the plant. The ash in one of those ponds has been in contact with the groundwater beneath for almost 50 years. Groundwater is held in a porous network of rocks beneath the Earth's surface called an aquifer. Ameren says the groundwater found beneath the Labadie plant is not used for drinking water, and the Environmental Protection Agency has separate contamination standards for groundwater beneath a public utility and groundwater used for drinking. Ameren's reports indicate that most of the contaminants in the groundwater beneath the ash ponds fall within the EPA standards for utility companies. In 2016, Ameren built a 166-acre coal ash landfill on the other side of the plant from the ponds. The landfill is lined at the bottom to protect against contaminating the groundwater beneath it. Both the ponds and the landfill are surrounded by large berms that protect them from floodwaters, but Shuba worries that rising water levels could eventually top those berms, spreading toxins from the ash away from the plant and towards residential water sources.
With climate change increasing the risk of significant storms, rainfalls, flash floods, and flooding in our floodplains over weeks and sometimes months, the risk is that that material will be in contact with our drinking water all the time. And that means that we're at risk of being exposed to those cold waste toxins that clearly can cause disease.
Labadie and the rest of the St. Louis area sit at the confluence of the Missouri and the Mississippi, the two longest rivers in the U.S. The area is highly susceptible to flooding from these and other smaller tributaries. Robert Chris is a hydrogeologist at St. Louis's Washington University. He says that groundwater plays a big role in the area's floods.
When it rains, you see the rivers go up, especially the small streams. Well, you think that's the immediate rainfall, this notion of overland flow, and sometimes that's true. But a really large component of that flow is displaced groundwater that's been in the system a long time. So it rains and you push out the old water.
In addition to the Labadie plant, Ameren owns and operates three other coal plants in the region. All are built and store coal ash along floodplains, either in ponds or solid waste landfills.
This is what the floods do.
Chris says that storing ash in a floodplain puts the area's aquifer at great risk.
The groundwater in the alluvial floodplains responds on a daily basis to the water level in the river. Now, the water can come and go, can move more than 100 yards a day, and any percolating waste will get into the water and move it out through the aquifer and so forth.
And rivers have been rising more and more often in the St. Louis area. This past spring, the region was hit by its biggest flood in more than 25 years. Environmental scientists link the flooding to an increase in storms caused by climate change. Rachel Bartels heads the Missouri chapter of the Waterkeepers Alliance, an international organization that monitors the water quality of rivers and streams.
St. Louis, and I think the Midwest in general, has always had somewhat erratic weather, but it has definitely, the storms have increased and the intensity of the storms has increased as well. You know, we've had major flooding events in the last few years. They're called 100-year floods for a reason.
Between March and July last year, water levels near the Labadee plant rose by almost 20 feet. Bartels and members of her group took aerial photos.
The coal plant was an island, you know, and knowing what we know about water, it just, when you look at it, it was such a powerful reminder that it is not the place to be storing this toxic waste.
The high flood waters we had this year.
But while flood waters did rise near the Labadee plant, they never topped the berms surrounding the coal ash. That's according to Warren Wood, Ameren's vice president of legislative and regulatory affairs.
Fortunately, at our different basins, they've been designed with different perimeter berms. We have water treatment in the event any water does get into the basins. And here at Labadee, we haven't had any flooding that got into any of the basins. And so the berms have been, you know, performed as designed, and we haven't had flooding in our basins.
In accordance with Environmental Protection Agency rules, Ameren uses independent consultants to monitor the groundwater around its property at wells like this one. In addition, Ameren's consultants analyze groundwater close to homes near the plant, as well as the surface water of the Missouri River that flows next to it. It says none of its samples exceed the EPA's groundwater protection standards.
We didn't have any impacts of groundwater on any of the groundwater checks around our property boundary or in the river or in the surface water in the area. The only hits were a few of the wells in the immediate vicinity of the basins where we did have some metal that we detected.
But Robert Chris is skeptical of those findings.
It's a biased result if your own paid consultants are doing the work.
Ameren stands by its consultants' findings and says it plans to cap all its ash ponds in the St. Louis region to protect them against future floods. Regardless, hydrogeologist Robert Chris says that the groundwater beneath the plant may be beyond saving.
If you pollute groundwater, there is no way to ever clean it up because you've polluted your canteen. And so when we misuse our floodplains and our aquifers, We are robbing our future in ways that we cannot imagine.
But Warren Wood believes that Ameren's plan will reduce contaminants in the groundwater beneath the ash ponds. He also says that capping the ponds and leaving them in place is the safest option in the long run.
If you go to an excavation approach, you're looking at up to 3 decades, and you're going to leave these basins open that entire time for more water filtration to potentially pick up metals and move into the groundwater.
Wood told NewsHour Weekend that Ameren's coal ash facilities are built to withstand what he terms a massive flood event.
Last week, North Carolina announced an agreement with Duke Energy to excavate and remove nearly 80 million tons of coal ash. The state says it will be the largest such cleanup in American history.